does it truly take to be king of the beach? When even those who seem invincible feel the pain. It's a test of power and a test of strength. It's a test of human survival. And in order to pass, one must overcome the struggle between body and mind. And if he does, he will be king. Setting for beach volleyball. We are just outside the beautiful Grand Floridian Beach Resort at Disney World. The Magic Kingdom, just a jump serve away. And today, the best beach volleyball players in the world are here for the final event of the season. It's the $175,000 Old Spice King of the Beach Invitational. Hello again, everybody, and welcome. I'm Chris Marley. You know, all season long, the top teams on the beach battle it out to see who is best. But once a year, a tournament comes along, a special kind of tournament that changes all that. The King of the Beach Invitational, a tournament designed to determine who is the best all-around individual player on the beach. That's what we have for you today. Happy to have working with me a man who was always a team player, my partner Paul Sunderland. What does it take to win this tournament?
Well, first and foremost, this is the most difficult challenge the AVP players face all season long. And ironically, Karchke Rye's partner during the regular season and so successful with Kent Steffes chose not to play here for, again, the second year in a row. Now, what does it take to win? First of all, you have to have all the volleyball skills. Otherwise, the opposition will find out your weaknesses in a big hurry. You've got to be in phenomenal shape because the conditions here are treacherous. We've seen that year in, year out. But I think more importantly, you get to the mental side. You've got to develop immediate chemistry with a new partner each and every match. You've got to have his respect. He has to have yours. And, you know, above all else, you've got to have character if you want to be king of the beach. It's in a word. You better be a character.
The format at the King of the Beach, it's much like the Clinton health plan. Very, very complicated. Can you explain?
Well, I'll straighten them out later, but I'll straighten you and the audience out. Here we go with the format for the King of the Beach. 3 days, individual round-robin competition, changing partners continuously. You win points and money every time you take the court, and of course win. You put some money in the bank, points on the board, until we get to the final day and we name the individual King of the Beach.
The top six players in the season-long AVP rankings received byes into the second day of competition. And when Kent Steffes elected not to compete, there was a tie for the final spot between Brazilian partners Loyola and Anjinho. Loyola won the coin toss and became a spectator on day one. And what about Anjinho? He trotted off to work. Tim Hovland, three-time former world champion, going up against one of the most charismatic players in beach volleyball, the king of Baltimore this year, Scott Akatubby. While they jousted for position, where would you expect to find the reigning king? Touring the kingdom, of course. In this case, the Magic Kingdom. Karch with his wife Jana and their sons Corey and Christian.
Okay, we're gonna go around and get in here.
Yeah, over there. On qualifier day, it's great to be king.
Oh, I just can't wait to be king.
And finally, when his tour is over, Karch dropped in looking fresh as a daisy from his e-ticket ride.
Their showdown for the last spot in the final eight, Tim Hovland had a slim advantage over Scott Akatubby. Two wins to Ak's one. But all Ak had to do was to beat Tim Hovland by more than 2 points to secure his ticket to the show. Ak started strong, jumping to a quick 11-2 lead. And suddenly, the Hov was struggling. Moments after the match, Scott's ability to continue was in serious doubt.
You know, he played a great day today. It was close. I think the heat got to him a little bit in the last match. He's looking like he's locking up in there. It's going to be a long, hot day tomorrow, so I'm going to be ready, waiting in the wings. If he can't play, I'll be ready and willing and able to play.
Ak was the qualifier for day two, but he was not looking good at this point, receiving fluids and IV treatment. Hovland standing by to take Ak's place. Now, Ak's competition in Pool A, Karch Karai, Randy Stoklos, and Adam Johnson. Remember, each player will play 3 matches, rotating partners within the pool. Meanwhile, in Pool B, Mike Dodd, Mike Whitmarsh, teammates during the year, Jose Loyola, and Brian Lewis. And hot as day one. Straight ahead, 3 grueling matches for each player. Day two introduced 3-time defending champion Karch Karai to the competition. For Karch, a surprise partner in match one.
Never was dead.
Tim Hovland had been eliminated, or so it seemed, on day one.
No, Ak's dead.
I talked to one of the medical staff late last night, and he just said it would take me 3 to 4 days to fully rehydrate my body, and he didn't think I'd be able to make it through one game tomorrow, and I definitely agreed.
With Ak gone, the Hov became the pivotal player in Karai's run at a 4-straight title. And once again, Hov would be tested by the heat. Season-long partners Adam Johnson and Randy Stoklos beat up on Karai and Hovland. Karai was frustrated, and Hovland was gassed. They lost 15-4. However, Karch and Adam took advantage in the next match, winning by 11. The Hov, about to play his 6th match in 2 days, needed to win by at least that many to pass Karch and move on to Sunday. In the 3rd match of the day, AJ inspired Hov to victory, in the process eliminating his old partner, Randy Stoklos. But helping the Hov to reach a milestone. $1 million in career earnings. Karch also made it. However, the reigning King of the Beach only won one match and trailed Adam Johnson in the standings.
Well, in Group B, after two matches, all four players still had a chance to advance. Holding a slim lead, Mike Dodd, 15-year veteran of the Pro Beach Wars, and this year, finally, Defensive Player of the Year.
I got a little choked up at the banquet because it was so funny. I really wanted to give Mike Whitmarsh a lot of credit for the blocking that he had done for me this year, and I really wanted to give Tim Hovland a whole lot of credit for all the blocking he did for me over a decade when we were playing together. But, you know, I could barely talk because I just couldn't get, you know, kind of the vision of my dad who had died this past year out of my head, just because he had been so furious in the previous awards banquets when I'd come home and not won the defensive player, and every time he'd just go, you know, you deserve to win. What's this, you know? So I just couldn't get him out of my mind, and just the thought of him up there smiling and being happy that I finally won it.
Mike Dodd, a fabulous career winding down, became the key player in the final match of the day in Pool B as we pick it up 14-11.
Unbelievably, all four players are still alive. Now, the Brian Lewis scenario, he must win this match with Mike Dodd in order to advance. Lewis on the brink of elimination just a few points ago. Meanwhile, the Jose Loyola scenario, he could have advanced along with his partner Mike Whitmarsh had they closed it out at 15-10. It's now 14-11. He faces the prospect of playing off against Mike Whitmarsh now for that final playoff spot. They are hot, Paul.
And Mike Whitmarsh knows, having played with Mike Dodd all season long, that you never give the great veteran a second chance. Remember Seal Beach in the comeback.
A reminder, if players are tied with identical one-loss records after the day, point differential is the deciding factor. Brian Lewis with the serve.
Go back.
And right to Dodd, chance for another point. Dodd, and he puts it away.
Kristen, with that swing, Mike Dodd advances to the final four on point differential.
Now the only question, who is going with Dodd? Will it be Loyola, Whitmarsh, or Dodd's partner, Brian Lewis? Remember, Lewis has to win to have a chance. So Dodd is in. He is going to the final day. Lewis serving 12-14.
Nobody.
Whitmarsh, oh, are they struggling? Another point coming up, maybe. Lewis. Yes!
Once it starts to slip away, it is so hard to just grab a hold and get control of the match once again. All four players exhausted. You can bet Mike Dodd knows his situation in terms of points that he is in, trying to bring his partner for now with him. But his old partner all season long, Mike Whitmarsh, is on the ropes.
Yes, get out of here, line!
Stop! 14-14. And Lewis is loving it.
But conserving his energy, celebrating in a very mild manner, particularly for Brian Lewis. Big block by Dodd.
Remember, you must win by two. Loyola and Whitmarsh are in the tank. They've given up four in a row. Lewis again, and he misses it.
Boy, maybe a time, Chris, to take a little something off the jump serve. I know Louis hits it hard and has good velocity and location on it, but Whitmarsh and his partner Loyola are gassed.
How do you get mentally back into it if you're Whitmarsh and Loyola?
You just got to suck it up. Look at the clock, look at the situation, and recognize the rewards. Think about making one big play.
See the time remaining as Lewis chops it down the line. Just 18 seconds to go in this one.
18 seconds remain.
Remember, if the clock runs out, you only have to be leading by one. 14-14. Dodd sends it up.
Line.
Blocked. Whitmarsh trying to save a point. And the ball is down. It's on Whitmarsh. No. It goes down on Dodd's side. Side out.
joust, open hand push coming from both players, matching Kong. The ball comes down inside Mike Dock. Big play by Loyola. And they get the advantage here because Loyola, the much tougher jump serve you saw before when Whit Marsh and Dodd were trying to score. Whit's got the lollipop.
Question is, how much steam Loyola can get on his jump serve? Well, wait a second. He's not even going to jump serve. He's going to float serve. 6 seconds to go. Lewis needs to win to advance. Loyola Whitmarsh, if they win, they play off. Lewis. And Whitmarsh has got it up. And he puts it away. Just barely pulling it out at the end. Big defensive play by Mike Whitmarsh, learning all season long from partner Mike Dodd. Loyola crawling his way back to shake hands, but play will go on.
Dodd has advanced. Lewis has been eliminated. Whitmarsh and Loyola will play off for the second and final spot in the Final Four.
Way Jose.
One more point.
Loyola, it's not one more point. You got to play for another full minute against your former partner. It's between you and Mike Whitmarsh for a chance at the Final Four. Your partners to be determined next.
First up,
Whitmarsh and Lewis.
Whitmarsh and Lewis. Gage drew out Whitmarsh and Lewis. They would play together as a team. The other team was Jose Loyola and Mike Dodd. Mike Dodd taking the youngster Loyola under his wing.
Mike is in. He can bring Jose with him.
We're gonna serve.
In the West, Sam.
Yes, sir. Whitmarsh. You block that high line, and I'll get the angle.
1 minute.
Okay.
1 year ago, playing in near identical conditions, Mike Whitmarsh suffered meltdown. In fact, his inability to endure extreme heat defined most of his career. Until this year, Whit enjoyed his best season ever on the beach. Now, in a one-minute playoff, Whit looked through the net at a man who helped him resurrect his career, Mike Dodd. But now Dodd was helping another player fading in the heat, Jose Loyola. Cramping up from dehydration, Loyola leaned on Dodd. And with Dodd's support, Loyola prevailed in overtime, claiming the fourth and last spot in the final. Mike Whitmarsh was done. For the win, Loyola paid a heavy price. In the players' tent after the match, Jose suffered total lock, head-to-toe cramps, and was given 4 liters of intravenous fluids. Still, Loyola looked forward to 3 more matches on the final day.
I hope you are right, much more. I hope so. Thank you.
Up next, the final day. Only 4 remain in the King of the Beach. Lies a world of dreams, where each man rules his own kingdom. Adam Johnson pictures a place where he would reign by universal acclaim, acknowledged at last for the breadth of his skills. Mike Dodd's ascent to the throne would be the crowning achievement of a long and glorious career. A foreigner in their midst, Jose Loyola would rule with style and flair. Looming in everyone's vision, the reigning king, Karch Karai. These 4 have built their dream castles stone upon stone with determination and sweat. Today, one man will make the leap from imagination to reality and live his dream. Today, one man will rule. This was the setting for day three of the King of the Beach Invitational at Walt Disney World here in Orlando, Florida. The weather cool and overcast. Big change from the first 2 days. Perfect weather for tired volleyball players like Jose Loyola. How was the young Brazilian feeling?
Good, much better. I'll be all right for today.
So Jose was okay. Meanwhile, it figured to be an uphill battle for the reigning King of the Beach, Karch Karai. In fourth place with a 1-2 record after day two, Karch Karai cast in the underdog role. Adam Johnson was in command after a perfect day two.
The first match of the final round was huge. A rejuvenated Loyola with a determined Karai against an ageless Mike Dodd and an undefeated Adam Johnson. Johnson would strike first. As expected, Karai would not go quietly. Or without paying nearly the ultimate price. This shot long by Loyola would get AJ and Mike Dodd back in the match. At 13-12, this is how we call it.
AJ cleaning the goggles, getting ready to serve. His team trailing by one. What an opportunity for Adam Johnson.
And thinking about just one thing. First match of the morning, getting rid of Karch Karai and Loyola, an added bonus. Get rid of them both first thing of the day.
Johnson to serve. His serve has been very effective so far.
Good.
Working on Loyola. Yeah.
Nobody.
And Loyola puts it right down the middle. Loyola's looked pretty good on the right, hasn't he?
Yeah, I was going to say exactly that. He has really made a nice adjustment after playing all season long on the left with his partner, Angino. One of the reasons he's done so well in the King of the Beach, remember last year he was second, he can play both sides.
And Loyola jump serve error, so the side out to Mike Dodd and Adam Johnson. Loyola, 24 years old, one of the rising stars on tour. Adam Johnson at the net and 37-year-old Mike Dodd serving. Karch, and it's dug up. Chance for a point. Dodd. Not yet. Loyola blocks it. Dodd. Not yet. Loyola blocks it. And it's out of bounds.
Some question about Loyola's legs coming into this final day. I'll tell you, that's answered right now. Four bags, about 20 bottles of water, a kilo of bananas. He's ready to rock and roll.
And after all that, just a side out. Karai to serve, his team leading by one, 13-12. And Johnson drools it down the line. Good shot for AJ. His shots look very, very good.
Well, especially back on the left side, where he really made his mark on the Pro Beach Tour. He's been very successful on the right this year with Randy Stoklos, but he's a 10 on the left.
Johnson trailing by one.
Good. Cut.
Loyola, Johnson's got it. Chance to tie it right here. And he puts it away.
Time score 13-13.
AJ with a nice transition play going to his favorite towel. Again, digging the ball down the line. I'll tell you, he starts salivating right now, being able to transition from the left. Everything happening in front of him, going high hands against Loyola. Karai can't make the play.
Tied at 13. Playing to 15.
Good. Over.
Loyola easily gliding, and he sure looks like he's got his second win.
Well, it's great to be a kid, you know, on your deathbed one day and just back looking great the next. Very comfortable on the right side, particularly passing the ball.
13-13, Loyola serving.
You!
Yeah. Little tip, Karch has it. And Loyola is dug up by Dodd. Dodd got it!
Defensive Player of the Year, Mike Dodd, making his father very proud once again. Great play down the angle against Loyola, saving the play.
Dodd with the serve.
Over.
And Loyola punches it through for a side out. Keep in mind that Karsdorff, a must-win situation for him. If he loses, he cannot repeat as King of the Beach.
Same situation for his partner Loyola. If he also loses here, he is eliminated as well. First match of the day.
Karai serving, tied at 13. Trouble here. Johnson again, and he whacks it.
AJ just hammering. Final day, looks strong, looks fresh. Again, three easy wins yesterday may well have helped him in terms of his conditioning for the final day.
Adam Johnson, the former U.S. champion. He's won two majors in his career, and he's trying to dethrone Karch Karai. If he can win this match, he will knock out Karch.
All season long, players have said, look, you can't give Karai, in unusual cases with Steffes, the same diet. You got to change it up. They've been serving Loyola, working on Loyola, and AJ snuck in the jumper on Karch and caught him napping for the ace.
First game point for Dodd and Johnson.
One.
And Karch goes over the top. 18, so a side out for Loyola and Karai. Adam Johnson, his first chance to put away Karch, could not do it. Loyola will serve.
Karch does not have a lot of practice at being the underdog.
Adam!
Okay.
Johnson got it up. See the clock going. Karch ties it up!
Loyola with the outstanding bump set off the soft block from Karch Karai. He knows the importance of everything that's going on right now for himself, most of all, but certainly for his partner as well.
Loyola serving to take the lead.
And cut!
Loyola digs it up. Time is running out. Loyola puts it away. Wait a second. There's still a second left. Game is not over. But it's virtually over.
It's been done before by that man, Adam Johnson. But you have to wonder what AJ is thinking. Had a chance to eliminate Karai and Loyola.
Next point. Helps you a lot.
Anything.
Next point.
Yes.
You want to serve tough?
Smart
AJ. You know, serve the way you want.
Karch then, go ahead, serve it hard. Loyola needs some points.
So does Karch.
And that's an ace. Good enough. So the king is not dead quite yet, but he gets a lot of help from the young Brazilian Jose Loyola. And ended short of its goal. At age 37, Dodd failed in his quest to be the king, yielding before the challenge of Karch Karai and Adam Johnson in match two. Jose Loyola, so heroic in match one, shared Dodd's frustration. Partners in defeat, their only remaining role is to support the two surviving contenders. Chris Marlowe back with Paul Sunderland. The championship final is set. It comes down to Karch Karai and Adam Johnson. One of those two players will be the King of the Beach. Maybe the biggest match of Adam Johnson's career in terms of respect.
Well, I think so, absolutely. Adam Johnson has had his moments in his pro beach volleyball career, but not for a while. And if he wants to be considered in the same breath, in the same class as Karch Karai, then he has to beat Karch. It's Adam Johnson's chance to be King of the Beach.
Adam Johnson says, you're the king, and Karch says, yeah, and you have to beat me to take the title. Mutual admiration as Karch serves first. Johnson, and he rolls it in. Let's identify the players for you. Adam Johnson, white tank top, blonde hair, sunglasses. His partner in this one, Jose Loyola. Yellow headband, sunglasses at the net. And Johnson is into the net. On the opposing side, the veteran, Karch Karai, 33 years old in the pink hat. And of course, the ageless veteran, his partner, Mike Dodd. Looking for the first point right here. Karch on the right. Score it. 1-0.
Got to think chemistry here a little bit at the top of this match. Remember, Karch Karai came back from a big deficit early in the final match last year with Mike Dodd, who was so courageous in that match. I think they got to come in with a lot more confidence than Loyola and Adam Johnson.
Serve is out of bounds. Dodd serving the lollipop. It floated on him. Now Jose Loyola will serve for his team. 1-0. And he serves out. How much pressure is on Loyola right now?
A lot. Adam Johnson has lost only one match, that to Loyola and Karch Karai earlier in the tournament. Loyola wants to return the favor, help Adam Johnson win his first crown.
Karch with the serve. And he aces. That makes it 2-0.
Have to wonder about Loyola's condition. Of course, so tired the day before and looked good earlier on, but very tired looking in match two. We'll see how he does here in the final match of the day to decide it.
Down the line, Johnson. Nobody. And Johnson taps it down the middle. Kind of interesting. Johnson knows he has to outplay Karch Karai, but he also knows that his partner Loyola must outplay Karch's partner, Dodd.
And Mike Dodd has taught Loyola so much about the game since Loyola came up from Rio de Janeiro just a couple of years ago. They practice and play together all the time.
Jose up high.
Karch Karai going for the patented cross court, and Loyola says, no way, Jose. It has been a long, long, grueling competition. Sign right there, Adam Johnson taking the IV treatment right before the finals, allowed by the rules.
Good serve by Johnson. Dodd rejected. Jose Loyola again.
Adam Johnson with a very good jump serve and ball control right now, kind of failing Dodd and Karai.
In the final match, the competition between Johnson and Karai. And Johnson is into the net.
To think back for a minute to last year when Adam Johnson couldn't answer the bell in the final match. He had made it to the final four but was replaced by Randy Stoklos with Loyola. Karai and Dodd going on and winning that match, and Karai winning that title.
Won't happen this year. Cool and breezy conditions on the final day have made the playing conditions bearable for the players, so everybody looks fairly fresh at the moment. Loyola serving 2-2. Karch rejected again,
this time by Johnson. There's the one-on-one competition, and AJ getting the better of it.
People conjectured was the second toughest major at UCLA, biochemistry, the first being physics, I think. And I was all planning on maybe playing through the Olympics in 1984, taking a year off or so, and then applying to medical school. And literally, that situation changed overnight. In the matter of about 12 hours, we won the gold medal on a Saturday evening 10 years ago. And by the next morning, they called a team meeting and said, hey, guys, there are a whole lot of new sponsors who are would be very sad to have this team break up just as it had won a gold medal. Want to keep you guys together and be able to pay you some money to do it? And I said, well, great. So I stuck with the team, as it turned out, 5 more years after that.
Well, I, for one, Paul Sunderland, am very happy Karch Karai chose to be a volleyball player instead of a doctor.
Well, and I for two. Thank you, Karchy.
Johnson and Loyola with the lead, and Loyola is into the net. You know, the weather could be a factor here. Foreboding clouds, there is a chance of rain.
Well, with the cloud cover certainly come cooler temperatures. The player's thankful of that, but if it rains and rains a lot, it will affect how the game is played.
Pretty good serve by Karch, and Johnson cranks it down the middle.
AJ having a lot of success going deep middle when he's in trouble. Dodd and Kirai have to adjust their defense just a little bit. Dodd really hovering to the line.
Karch, the reigning king of the beach, and the only man who has a chance to unseat him, Adam Johnson.
Good.
AJ.
Line. Come on.
And Johnson with a dig. And a little pinball defense. Dodd. And Dodd puts it away.
Mike Dodd coming through for his partner, Kirai. Once again, Loyola, very quick spin, getting to that ball defensively after Adam Johnson had made the play.
Mike Dodd with the serve.
Line. No.
And it's off Karch. It landed on the line and a side out.
Lucky break that time. AJ dropped his shoulder, hit the ball weakly off the top of the tape, just dribbled down the sideline. But you need that kind of luck sometimes if you're going to win against a player like Kirai.
Good.
And Dodd hitting deep once again. So Karch will have the ball. You know, one rule I'd like to see them institute in the King of the Beach: the guys that could be king have to serve each other the whole game. Karch has to serve Johnson. Johnson has to serve Karch the entire game. What do you think?
If you miss him, you get a let. AJ, I'm not sure AJ likes the rule. He just got aced by his main and only competitor. Kirai going hard cross court. AJ hovering way into the middle. Remember all the hubby wife serves deep middle earlier on in the competition, protecting that area.
3-3 is our score. Here comes Johnson. And Johnson crunches another one. Johnson playing the entire year on the right side with Randy Stoklos. How would you evaluate their year real quick?
Oh, disappointed.
I mean,
everybody called him Dream Team 2 after Kirai and Steffes. I think that a good year for them would have been winning half a dozen tournaments and finishing up in the top three or four on a consistent basis, and they didn't do that.
Tied at three, Johnson serving.
Cut.
Dodd blocked. Loyola goes and gets it. He's out, and he puts it away.
An athletic play by Loyola. How long is he down? Just the bat of an eye, turns, sneaks a look to see where Kirai is. He says, hey, he's right in front of me. I'm just going to bomb the ball right at him.
One of the best plays on the beach this entire season. Johnson and Loyola leading by 1-4-3.
Nobody.
Dodd deep again. That's by design, isn't it?
Oh, absolutely. Dodd doesn't have quite the heat that he used to or the vertical, so he uses the entire court, slices it down the sidelines, and will certainly use the back 2 or 3 feet of the court.
Johnson, Dodd is there, and he scores! Wow.
He loves playing defense. He can still scramble. Did not mean to shoot that ball over and two, just trying to get it back to the net to his partner, Kirai, and Johnson and Loyola went to sleep on it.
One reason why Dodd was the AVP Defensive Player of the Year. Loyola stuffed. Oh, pinky hat got him.
Loyola knows that Dodd is hovering back there, tries to challenge Karch, and you got to make big, dramatic blocking moves on the beach. You want to take a lot of court, Karch jumping way into the angle.
5-4.
Nobody.
And nobody indeed.
I tell you, they're serving Adam Johnson because he's on the right side, but I think more importantly, they want to force Loyola to set the ball well. And so far, he certainly passed that test.
Loyola in jump serve posture.
Good.
Good serve. Dodd goes and gets it. Right on the line that time. Pretty good set by Kirai. Kirai, once again, the three-time defending champion. Mike Dodd has never won this event.
Everybody bump setting except for Karch Kirai. If we get rain, he will bump set as well.
Ace! Karch Kirai elevating his game right now. His team leads 6-4. doing his thing, shaking and baking. Goofy likes it. Everybody likes it. Marvin Hall's not a Disney character, but Chip and Dale are, and they're getting into his action. Not Frontierland, not Tomorrowland. Marvin Hall, the mayor of Funkville.
Marvin huffing and puffing just a bit after that performance.
Starts to ride back to center. 6 points.
Hey, Marvin! Marvin, you ready?
Where's the oxygen for the referee?
That was first referee Jim Leonard saying, Marvin, are you okay to continue? 6-4, Karai and Dodd leading by two. Johnson, and Johnson goes over the top and down.
Tattooing the sideline, Kirai coming in on the sharp angle, and AJ using all of the court, going over Kirai into the deep cross-court corner.
4-4 tie, then Johnson and his partner Loyola got two quick ones. And the rain has started to come down here in Orlando, Florida.
You won't see Kirai set the ball much with his hands if it rains hard.
Dodd, and AJ pokes it back over. Karch, and Karch rips it.
Kirai and Dodd so experienced, really being careful to communicate. You hear Mike Dodd yelling out directions of where Karch should go offensively after he sets the ball.
And Dodd floats it in. His team leading 6-4. Loyola.
I think you got to block against him on a good set. You can't just stay back and admire his ability to bomb the ball. Pretty undiggable when he's set well.
Karai, one of the featured players. His partner Mike Dodd in a supporting role today.
Ace! Wait a second.
Dodd's hands came flying up. He thinks it's out. Loyola thinks it's in.
Wow, that was very, very close.
It was good. It was not sand. Ball hit it on the way out.
Referee Jim Leonard saying, hey, I saw it. It was in.
Tough jump serve, and neither Dodd or Kirai, they're not whiners. They don't complain on calls unless they think they've got a legitimate argument. That's a big play by Loyola to get his team on the scoreboard. Once again, comes back, tries for a cup one and misses it, but he did get the one ace.
6-5, Kirai and Dodd lead. Karai and Dodd, once a team back in 1985. They won three tournaments that year. Then Karai went back onto the USA national team, ending that partnership. Here comes Loyola. Blocked. Right over to AJ. And he crunches it. Adam Johnson has been nearly flawless here at the King of the Beach.
The important thing too, Chris, is the trajectory work that he's hitting the ball with. He's hitting the ball off the top of Dodd over the defense of Karch Kirai, hitting the ball very, very deep, like Mike Dodd, the opposition.
You can see the drops starting to come down heavily now. Johnson serving.
Come on, Karch.
Yeah, no one.
Karch. Oh, and Johnson digs him. And he puts it away. He dug the king.
Look at this reaction by Adam Johnson. Just barely got his hands together. Pops the ball straight up in the air. Loyola questioned all season long by both of us about his setting. That one nectar, AJ, goes with the score.
Tied at 6. Johnson for the lead. Oh. AJ with a dig.
Watch it.
Over it. AJ with another dig. He's on fire now. Hooked up. Dig! Score!
Johnson fighting off a smile because he knows just how big a play that was. Johnson with a couple of great digs, but look at this. Turned back across his body for the little knuckle pokey. This is the rainbow, and I mean rainbow dink. And Dodd can't get there.
Stand timeout.
Timeout called by Karai and Dodd. Johnson and Loyola have scored 3 in a row. Beach. Meanwhile, Adam Johnson in his 6 years on the beach has been moderately successful. How would you compare Johnson and Steffes?
It's hard to compare Kent Steffes and myself. From the standpoint, he's got a great partner. I think if roles were reversed, I think I'd be in the same situation as he's in. Unfortunately, that's not the case. I'm having to work and get all aspects of my game better, which I think I've been doing this last season. And it's tough, no doubt, but hopefully I'll find that partner that's going to be there 100% for me.
Adam's partner of this year, Randy Stoklos, right there. How happy is he with Stoklos?
Well, he'd be a lot happier if they won more often. They won only three tournaments this year and certainly expecting to have greater success. I'm interested to see what happens at the beginning of next season.
Adam Johnson serving. His team has scored three in a row. And they're working on Dodd. Dodd, and he punches it through.
Just had another quick look at the Band-Aid on Adam Johnson's arm where he took the IV treatment. Obviously, he felt he needed it and has looked very, very fresh coming into this final match for the championship.
Six serving seven in a game to 15.
Line, come
AJ.
On.
And AJ rules it down the line. So Johnson gets the kill. He'll stay at the net this time, and his partner, Jose Loyola, will serve.
And don't be surprised to see Adam Johnson at the net. Underrated as a blocker, but pretty solid and effective. And Loyola's played good defense throughout the King of the Beach competition.
Loyola served too strong. Karchin Dodd led 6-4, but then a Loyola ace made it 6-5. Johnson made two great digs, and a kill made it 6-6. And then AJ, a little pinball defense. That's where we stand right now, 7-6. Johnson.
Again.
Wow.
Not showing him enough respect. Loyola with a good set, and both Dodd and Kirai back off playing defense, figuring they can score a point off Adam Johnson, even swinging at the open net, and they can barely touch him.
To this point in the King of the Beach, Johnson has been the best player. That serve into the net. Remember, the competition is between Adam Johnson and Karch Karai. Individual competition to be the King of the Beach.
Nobody.
Hey, Johnson's getting a workout over there.
Yeah, he's going to get to decide his own fate. This is between Karch Karai and Adam Johnson, and Dodd and Karai are working on Adam Johnson, and time again, he comes through, puts the ball away. If he wins, he will have earned it.
Loyola.
Over it.
Dug up, but out of bounds. One thing Loyola needs to work on in his game is his defense.
Well, he spends his entire summer blocking in front of Anginho, his Brazilian teammate. Doesn't get to dig the ball very often.
Trailing by one is Karai. Good serve, but another good stab by Johnson. And he whacks another one.
Hey, that's the portrait right there. Adam Johnson being served continuously, either the lollipop from Dodd or the tough jumper from Karch Kirai. He's passing well, and then when challenged, hammering the ball up the middle or hard cross court.
AJ by one.
Go short.
Over. And it's down the middle. Mike Dodd keeping things hanging. Dodd will never be accused of using steroids. He will serve.
Drug test not necessary.
Here comes Johnson, and Johnson puts it away again. And the crackle of thunder in the distance.
And the last thing Adam Johnson wants right now is a delay or a stoppage of play because of thunder and lightning. Matt Gage, AVP official on site, will be the one to decide whether or not play continues.
Over him.
Here's Dodd. And the dig. Jose got it. And he puts it away. That makes it 8-6.
Doesn't get to play much defense, but getting plenty of practice in King of the Beach. Not a great set way inside. Loyola powerfully gets to the ball, big strides, and then whips it down the line.
Karch Karai is the only man who's ever won a King of the Beach title. Jose Loyola trying to help his partner, Adam Johnson, get there. They lead by two. Karch. And Karch sneaks one through.
Karch and Dodd talking strategy right now. I think certainly have noticed that Adam Johnson very effective hitting the ball. Maybe challenge Loyola. Make Adam Johnson set the ball. Get him out of his rhythm.
And Karch is working on AJ. And AJ has been beautiful. His shots have been meticulously placed. He's hitting off the net. When it's close, he sizzles it.
Been served nonstop, whether the jumper from Kirai or the floater from Dottie's passing the ball well, and his partner in the yellow headband, Loyola, setting the ball perfectly.
Eight serving six, and it's into the net. This match seemed to turn around. Johnson and Loyola were trailing 6-4, and Loyola served an ace that might have been in, might have been out. It was on the line, a little controversy. Since that time, Johnson and his partner have scored four in a row.
Now they go to Loyola.
And he cuts it inside. Clock could be a factor in this one. Under 2 minutes remaining in the game. Loyola to serve. Trouble. Dodd gets it up. And Cart shovels it back over. Right to Loyola. And he's out of bounds. Great save by Mike Dodd, who paid a heavy price, went into the banners courtside heavily. And Jim Leonard, the first referee, calling for a doctor.
Mike Dodd made a move towards the hubby wife area, got a late start. You can see the white PVC tubing that holds those courtside banners up.
Hit his face.
Yeah, Mike went into it face first.
I don't see anything blood on your lip, maybe inside.
Little blood coming from the bridge of the nose.
Yeah, a little bit.
And a little lip burger. Dodd's a warrior, however. He'll try to shake it off.
They'll have off-season plastic surgery, I guess.
A fabulous save by Dodd to keep Karai and Dodd within two. Medical timeout. We'll be back. We'll find out a little later. Johnson, he could be the side-out offensive player of the tournament, if there was such an award. He has been brilliant.
Well, deservedly so. You talked about the quality and quantity of his offense, but a real mistake there, and I'm surprised they didn't go after Loyola. You know, good opportunity to score. He hits the ball out of bounds, and then they served AJ, who offensively has been really, really good.
Johnson serving with a two-point lead. Dodd. And Dodd rips it down the line. Dodd at 37, once again the oldest player in beach volleyball. And he has really hung in there.
Six looking at eight.
Come on. They keep serving Johnson, and Johnson keeps putting it away.
Even when he gets a crummy call from his partner, Loyola said line. AJ said, forget that. I'm chopping cross court, and there was nobody home.
Johnson getting closer. Ace! Jose Loyola dials one up, and now Adam Johnson in a commanding position. And Karch Karai, the reigning king of the beach, in trouble. For Johnson, praying and hoping her husband, Adam Johnson, can hold on here. He leads 9-6. If he beats Karch, he is the new king of the beach. And there's only a minute, 5 seconds for Karch to come back. Chris Marlowe, Paul Sunderland, Loyola serving.
Going at Karch.
And Karch puts it away. Strategy for Karch and Dodd now.
Well, they have yet to find a way to score points. They serve AJ. They can't break him down. They serve Loyola, and they can't stop him. Have got to block a ball. Karch is probably going to go for the very, very tough jumper right now. Maybe at AJ.
Six serving nine.
Serving as hard as he can.
And Loyola. And Loyola rips it.
You know, this just might be a function of youth. I know Adam Johnson is 29, but they look crisp. They look fresher, and they're making the big plays athletically.
Loyola's at the net. Karch Karai maybe watching his King of the Beach title go out the window here in Florida. 55 seconds. It's a three-point lead for Johnson. The only thing I can see happening here is if Johnson and Loyola tighten up. If something were to happen, if they get a little out of their rhythm.
Well, AJ's just got to focus. He looks very focused to me. I don't think that he's even contemplating one play ahead or thinking about being the new king as yet. Off court, chance for a point. To Dodd. And it's dug up. Clock is running 43 seconds. Johnson, cut shot, yes. Oh, Johnson's cut shot has been beautiful.
3 seconds remaining.
Bad bump set by Kirat after the good block. Really hopscotched into good position to try to bump set that ball near the net and missed it.
Now, only 40 seconds remain for Johnson and Loyola. Good. Dodd. Ah! Johnson! A crowning block for AJ!
34 seconds remain.
Jennifer Johnson saying more. 10-6 now.
Now maybe AJ is thinking about it as Carson Kirai takes a 20. Jennifer Johnson is an author of children's books, and I think she may have found a new storyline.
Adam Johnson, who has played so well at the King of the Beach. He has finished second, he has finished third, he has finished fourth. This year, however, with a win, elevating himself into the higher echelon of players, the top of the game.
Well, Adam Johnson was there for a while. He came up about the same time as Kent Steffes. Kent Steffes has gone on to the greatest heights, playing with Karch Kirai. Adam Johnson's career has fallen off and gone in the other direction until today.
They're trying to go on two times. Someone touched the net. It was Dodd or Kirai point. And it appears now that Adam Johnson is going to become the King of the Beach. 29 seconds remain unless disaster hits Johnson and Loyola. AJ is going to wear the crown.
Dodd and Karch have to go very fast now.
They can't. Loyola with a dig.
Nobody.
And he puts it away. How about that? Could this team be a factor on the AVP Tour? Maybe.
Well, if they played together, they certainly would be.
Adam Johnson, 20 seconds away from victory. Going on to Karch. And Karch dunks it down. The first 3 years of this tournament. Well, it was Karch Karai's showcase.
Karai serving.
His 91, 92, 93. But times are a-changing. The weather is a-changing. And Adam Johnson, is 14 seconds away.
Back to serve.
A very calm king at the moment. Fans chanting AJ. Adam Johnson's wife and mother set to explode. Karch. And Karch loops.
Time out, Dodd and Kirai. 9 seconds
Adam
remaining.
Johnson can look at the scoreboard, look at the clock, and know that he is the new king of the beach.
Here comes Mike Dodd's version of the jump serve. He whacks it into the net. What a performance by Adam Johnson and Jose Loyola. Remember last year they couldn't play together because Adam Johnson cramped, had heat exhaustion, could not play in the final match. His place was taken by Sokolov. This year, a different story as Loyola trying to run out the clock cannot.
4 seconds.
One play remains.
But what level of performance when you look across the net and you see the legendary Mike Dodd and the greatest player of all time, Karch Kirai, and Adam Johnson has overcome it all to be the king of the beach.
Clock will tick. Karch serving hard. Adam Johnson is now the new Old Spice King of the Beach. AJ is king. Sutherland will talk to the brand new King of the Beach, Adam Johnson.
Watch his defense. Coming at you, Dodd. Johnson with a dig. Coming at you, Dodd. Johnson with a dig. Coming at you, Karch. Loyola. Dink and the score. That made it 7-6. Johnson, Loyola, Karai, and Dodd would not score another point. Let's go to Paul.
Some people said it couldn't happen, but there is a new king of the beach, and he's Adam Johnson. And you did it, beating Karch Kirai in the finals. The last couple of years have not been kind to you. What does this victory mean?
Well, I haven't quite thought about what it means to me yet. I'm still kind of in la-la land, but it definitely is another highlight in my career, and I'm just excited right now. I don't even know what to expect right now.
Have you ever played better over a couple of days?
I don't think so. You know, yesterday, so many people came up to me and said, God, your all-around game was great, your defense. I was blocking a lot of balls, something I don't usually do, but I've been practicing for this tournament, and it seemed to work out.
Great win, AJ, and congratulations. Back to you, Chris. The final standings, the top four, Adam Johnson takes home 54,500. Jose Loyola finishes second, Karai third, and in fourth, Mike Dodd. And speaking of Mike Dodd, our side-out defensive player of the tournament, also Mike Dodd, for his hustle and overall work in the tournament. Of course, Mike Dodd, the AVP Defensive Player of the Year, and it's his hustle that makes things pay off.
Doctor!
Oh, doctor, yes, oh, Dr. Dodd, his side-out Defensive Player of the Tournament. Once again, our congratulations to Adam Johnson and his wife, Jennifer. Adam Johnson is the new Old Spice King of the Beach, a touch of royalty. Yes, AJ, where's the crown? We hope you enjoyed the Old Spice King of the Beach Invitational from Orlando, Florida. For my partner, Paul Sunderland, I'm Chris Marlowe. The beach is now officially closed.